Hey, so since I've made my last video with landing pages, we've learned a lot being in Schoology and finding out how to do new things. So I wanted to show you again something else, how you can make a landing page very simple. So what you're seeing is my landing page that I made in Google Drawings. If we go back to my previous ones, like for instance this one is coming up made in slides. But if you make it in Google Drawings, it makes it so much larger. Let me show you how to do that really quick. Okay, so here I am in Slides, and notice this is the same one that will be in Drawings. So here's my drawings, and all I did was copy and paste it over to make it change the page setup to be the widescreen right here. So now what I need to do is once I've got all this set up is go into Schoology. So here is my course and this is what we're doing this week. So when I click on the folder, notice I have the weekly overview and then all the days. So when I click on the day that has the material in it, I just click on the folder and then up here in the top is the URL. So I'm going to copy that and then go back to my drawing. And because I used WordArt to make the text, it creates it like a picture so I can link it and then apply. And then I would go to day two, open that so I can get the URL, and then link that, and so on. Now you could set it up that way, or you can do the exact same thing with this. So if you wanted it to just link to your different courses, so these can be anything. The important part is the link that you're pulling from Schoology for that particular folder or activity. So now what I do is that is complete. Let's say I've linked all of those. I'm going to go into Schoology. I'm going to add a page, and this would be my landing page. I don't, it's not going to be shown, but just my landing page, it's got to house somewhere to do this. So I'm going to go to my Google Drive resource app and type in the title and embed this. So you see that it's really small. So if I click on it turns blue and then I click on the image. And usually 900 or 1,000 is really good. And so notice when I click off, it automatically sets the other one. And so then I'm gonna hit insert and then create. So now it's down here and I could unpublish it so nobody can see it. So now I'm gonna click on it and you're gonna see it. So now over here in the white space, I'm gonna kind of just click and drag and see how it's copied. It didn't highlight everything, but I've got it highlighted. I know that sounds weird, but it is. So I'm going to Command C or Control C. And then now I'm going to go to Updates. And in this box, I'm just going to Control V and paste it. And it's going to come in that size. And then I'm going to hit Post. Well, hit the bell and then Post. And so now it comes in the size of the screen. And so when they click day one, it automatically takes them to that day. The other thing you can do right here is adding a button down at the bottom that would take them back to home, which would take them back to this page right here. All right, so in order to add this button, this is how you do this. It's really quick. So what I did is you have to work in a Google Doc now, but I took the button from here and I just copied it. So Control C. And then I had to open up this Google Drawing, that page level navigational button. So it's a template for you. And I'm going to, in the box where the cursor is, I'm going to insert a drawing. And then notice I can paste my button here and make it as large as I need to. And then I'm gonna insert WordArt. And I typed my home and then made it fit. And then I hit save and close. So you see that I have my button. I just did that one for you. So now what I have to do is go back to the Schoology and get the home page, wherever it is you want them to land, where this is. Pull the URL, copy that. And then while this is highlighted, you can now insert a link. And so now when you copy this, Control C, you will go over here, edit the page, and down at the bottom, you can paste. And so now your home button is there. Hit save changes, and watch what happens when I click this. It takes me back to the navigational page. So that's how you do it. Please let me know if you have any questions. I'll be happy to help.